Welcome to the monthly release highlights for Okta's Workforce Identity Cloud. We will go over new generally available features and early access new features. Let's get started. Generally available features. Granular controls for authentication policies. Admins can now disallow or allow individual authentication methods for an authentication policy. This gives admins more granular control over access to apps. This feature is made available to all orgs. With granular controls for authentication policies, admins have more control over suitable authenticators and methods that users can use to satisfy assurance requirements. The list of all authenticators can be tailored to provide the ideal UX journey of different users and devices based on any policy attribute. Universal logout support for Zoom. Universal logout and identity threat protection with Okta AI now clears Zoom sessions and tokens when triggered by the entity risk policy. Continuous access and the clear user session function. This enhances the security of orgs that use identity threat protection. Universal logout instantly revokes compromised tokens to block access replay attacks across supported apps, prevents terminated and former employees from accessing company resources via active sessions, and forces end users to re-authenticate in case of a security or risky event. Remember last used authentication factor. Okta helps reduce user friction by prompting for the last used authentication factor. Previously, this was only available to those signing in through a web browser. Now, the last used authentication factor functionality is also available for thick clients and non-browser-based authentications. Enhanced sign-in experience for personal identity verification and common access card. The sign-in widget has been updated to provide an improved user experience when signing in with a PIV or CAC card. The new experience allows users to select a different authenticator if the PIV or CAC authentication fails, instead of forcing them to restart the sign-in process. If your org uses default error pages for PIV or CAC sign-in, the new experience is automatically enabled for the org. If your org uses customized error pages for PIV or CAC sign-in, they are preserved. However, you need to contact support to switch to the new experience. Sign in with duplicated email authenticators. Previously, users couldn't sign in if they had the same email and rolled twice as an authenticator. This change checks the status of each email authenticator and allows the user to sign in with the most suitable email authenticator. Option to enforce profile source priority for desktop single sign-on. Enforcing profile source priority for DSSO requires end users to authenticate using their identity from the top prioritized profile source. OIN connector support for entitlement management. The GitHub team connector has been updated to support entitlement management. Sign-in widget third generation version pinning. You can now pin the sign-in widget third generation version when updating a customized or preview sign-in page. You can pin version 7.8 or later. This ensures that orgs that use custom branding can't pin sign-in widget third generation to an incompatible version. Let's wrap up with a look at early access features. Multiple identifiers. Enhancements to the profile enrollment policy allow configuration of identifiers that can be leveraged for Okta sign-in flows using custom profile attributes. Today, end users must sign into Okta with a username or email address only. With the multiple identifiers feature, admins can configure identifiers or user attributes from Universal Directory that an end user can enter to authenticate. Multiple identifiers work in sign-on, recovery, self-service registration, and unlock flows. Admins can configure up to 3 identifiers, including email, which is still a required identifier. With multiple identifiers, admins can streamline the sign-in experience by giving users more options to identify themselves with. Admins can also specify which identifiers can be used across various applications. Require MFA for admin console access. You can now require multi-factor authentication to access the Okta admin console. When you enable this feature, all admin console authentication policy rules that allow single-factor access are updated to require multi-factor authentication. This will be enforced in a phased approach where the initial phase will prevent new admin console app authentication policies from being created without MFA and warnings will be surfaced for existing one-factor authentication rules. Requiring MFA to access the Okta admin console provides an additional security layer that can help reduce the likelihood of a breach. Enhancement to protected access to admin console as part of the require MFA for protected actions in the admin console feature. Step-up authentication is required to modify authentication policies applicable to admin console. This limits unauthorized actions from stolen sessions or tokens, even from the compromised device of a user with administrative permissions. This release provides an additional layer of protection for critical actions in Okta by requiring step-up authentication for admins to perform high-impact actions, minimizing the risk of malicious access, data breaches, and other security incidents. Skip the Verify page and redirect to the Identity Provider Authenticator. This feature allows users to skip the Verify step in the sign-in widget. They are instead redirected to the IDP Authenticator for verification. When you enable this feature, end users see the option to skip the sign-in widget verification. If your org is configured to remember the last authenticator the user used, then the user is auto-redirected to the IDP authenticator for future sign-in attempts. Okta Education Services is excited to announce new Workforce Identity Cloud on-demand training content and a new Okta Certified Access Gateway Specialty Certification released this month. Visit okta.com/training and okta.com/certification to learn more. Thanks for viewing the release highlights for Okta's Workforce Identity Cloud. For additional details, please visit the Okta release notes and help article links, which can be found in the video description.